Sight. was right. He looked hungry for his High School Musical glory days, and hungrier for something else. I was doomed to get a spot in the back of the chorus. Raul says, "Hello, everyone. It's so good to be back in my old home. I miss this so much. Jay, you better get your booty out of my old desk, you silly person." Yep, Jay was going to get the lead for sure, and possibly bend over a desk. Raul says, "Let's get these auditions started. Who's first?" The auditions went by extremely slowly. For every amazing performance, there were about six horrendous ones that deserved to end with stone throwing and possible guillotine situation. Then it was my turn, and I was horrified. I didn't know we were going to have to sing that day, so I didn't have a song prepared. So I performed something by heart, something, if done right, was sure to bring out some tears in the audience. Shane says, "Hi, my name is Shane, and I'm going to be singing A Moment Like This by American Idol winner Kelly Clarkson." Let's just say I'm no Kelly Clarkson. After my horrible rendition, I left the stage. Tara went after me. She sang some show tunes I had never heard before. It wasn't bad. I was actually impressed. I was so proud that I forgot I tanked and started beaming for her. She sat back down and grabbed her for a hug. And I grabbed her for a hug. There was a moment I thought she could actually get the lead, until I heard what came next. Patty says, "Hi, my name is Patty, and I'm going to be singing Somewhere Over the Rainbow." Not only did she blow it away, she actually cried while performing without missing a note. She was a true diva. She got a standing ovation from her peers, and Raul couldn't contain himself. He squealed with pleasure like a sadistic pig getting branded by a hot iron. She was seriously born to be a leading lady. There was no questioning it. The next day, the results were posted on the door of the chorus room right after school. Just like in the movies, we all ran there after the bell rang to see what our parts were. There was screaming, crying, and lots of fake hugging. Tara and I made our way up to the door and took a deep breath. Tara says, "Are you ready?" Shane says, "As long as I'm not a tree, I'll be happy." We both look and saw our fate. Tara was cast as the second lead, which was amazing. I was cast as Fat Funny Tourist. Fat was in the name, but trust me, after reading the script, I knew what it should have been. My only line was, "Who's hungry?" And I was wearing a safari outfit that was two sizes too small. Just like Patty, I was born for this role. The next day, we went to our first read-through. The cast was made up of a collection of many different types of people, but they were all nerds. There were the gay nerds, the book nerds, the chorus nerds, the drama nerds, and of course, the lesbian nerds. Although the lesbian nerds weren't in the cast technically, they were helping to build the sets and rig all the stage lighting. I for sure thought I wasn't going to fit in because I wasn't really a nerd. I was more of just a loser. And trust me, there's a difference. I wasn't super smart or in possession of some kind of awesome skill. I was just a normal fat dude with sweaty gland issues. The door opened and in walked a large woman with a look of menace smeared across her face. Everyone stopped talking and gave her their full attention. This was our director, Miss Welch. For the next 2 months, she would be the Ursula to my Little Mermaid. Miss Welch says, "Hello, I'm Miss Welch. I'm sure some of you have heard of me. If you haven't, you will. I don't take this job lightly. This musical will be perfect because it has to be. Anyone have a problem with that?" She was a true Disney villain. She had the face of a woman who killed puppies and ate them with a side of children's tears for dipping. She walked like a pirate with a wooden leg. She even had a belt made of rope. Every year, she would come to our school to direct the play, and none of us knew what she did out in the real world. I'm guessing she owned a shooting range. I knew this wasn't going to be easy, so I did what I knew how to do best. I tried to quit. I went to walk out the door, but was stopped by her large and in-charge arm. There was a collection of spider veins on it that looked like a GPS map of Los Angeles during heavy traffic. So many bold, dark lines. Miss Welch says, "Where do you think you're going?" Shane says, "I just remembered I can't do the musical because I have to do homework." Miss Welch, "Did you audition?" Shane, "Yes." Miss Welch, "Did you get a part?" Shane, "Yes." Miss Welch, "Do you think it's fair to your other castmates to leave them and force them to find a replacement? Do you think the president can just leave the White House and let them figure it out?" Shane, "I'm playing Fat Tourist. That's hardly the president." Miss Welch, "Sit down." Shane, "But..." Miss Welch, "If you don't sit down, I'll make you sit down. Me, technically, you can't." She flexed her big arm and the roads of Los Angeles expanded. I ran back to my chair in sheer terror. A week later, we started doing full rehearsals. We were on the auditorium stage working out our moves and our songs. In between songs, we would sit backstage and hang out while Miss Welch took care of our IBS in the bathroom. Most of the conversations between the kids were way more sexual than I expected. I had no idea that nerds got laid so much. I heard at least 3 different stories about braces getting caught on pubes, and 2 different stories about having sex with a protractor. It was truly enlightening. Patty never engaged in these conversations, though. She would sit by herself and read over her lines. She had a way about her that made her seem better than everyone else. But nobody was mad at her for that. Everyone felt that she really was better. It's probably similar to the way people treat Oprah. You just let her do her thing and don't bother her with your petty normal people problems. I felt a connection with Patty, but I was too afraid to talk to her. There was something about her that was sad that I couldn't put my finger on. I knew that deep down, underneath that perfect exterior, something was broken, and felt for sure it was something I could relate to. But instead of trying, I just left her alone until that big night. It was opening night, and our 2 months of hard work had finally paid off. We had rehearsed every day for 4 hours after school. Miss Welch might have been the devil in his suit, made of a human skin, but she was incredibly talented at getting kids to seem semi-talented on stage. If you wore earplugs and squinted your eyes halfway shut, you might have thought we were watching a real show. The auditorium was filling up with paying customers, and they were ready to be entertained. Backstage, we were all freaking out with excitement while Miss Welch walked around inspecting our costumes. Miss Welch, hike up those pants. Nobody wants to see your butt. Tuck in your shirt. Suck in that gut. She made her rounds until she got to the end of the line, which was me in my small safari costume. Miss Welch says, Shane, are you wearing an undershirt? Shane, yes, my mom calls it my sweatshirt. Miss Welch, cool, back behind this set and take it off. I want to see skin popping out between those stressed buttons. Shane, okay, Miss Welch, and if you see Patty, tell her to get her pretty butt over here. We were 5 minutes away from showtime. I went behind this set and standing in the darkness was Patty. She was hunched over crying behind a fake door. Her shirt was only half buttoned. Shane, I'm Patty. Patty, oh hey, I was just getting ready. Sorry, I'll be done in a minute. Shane, are you okay? Patty, huh? Oh yeah, fine. She sniffled and tried to play it off, but I knew something was up. Looking at her body, I knew exactly what her problem was. She wasn't fat by any means, but she was soft, and the shirt was trying to fit into was the most flattering for her figure. Shane, I'm going to ask wardrobe if they have a different shirt. Really? That's such a nice sound effect. Can you stop, please? Any minute now. Thank you. She sniffled an hour away. Okay, I'm going to ask the wardrobe if they have a different shirt. She looked at me in the eyes and saw something who really got her. What I saw was just a person who needed help. Patty, how bad does it look? Shane, not bad at all. Patty, I got nervous last night. I ate my brother's entire birthday cake. I feel so fat. Nothing is fitting. Everyone's going to laugh at me. Everyone is taking pictures and video. I'm going to look like a fat pig. Shane, you don't look fat, especially to me. Next to me. If you want, I can stand next to you during the cast photo. I can even eat a whole cake first. I skip my after-lunch snack so I can probably take you down and cake. Patty, you're not nervous. Shane, no, because I practice a lot and so did you. Even if you went out on stage and were the fattest person in the world, it wouldn't matter. Because when you open your mouth to sing, it will shut the entire auditorium up. Everyone will forget about everything and only be able to focus on your voice. You are seriously the best singer I've ever heard. And I'm not just saying that. Patty, really? Yeah. Sorry, this is Shane. Yeah, and hearing you say that, you feel fat makes me really happy. Because that means you aren't perfect. Because darn it, it was getting really hard not to secretly hate you. Patty, thanks. She finished getting ready. I took off my undershirt and got my costume back together. Shane, now let's go out there and kick some butt. She gave me a hug and we walked out together, ready to kill it. The show was a success in some ways. Patty was amazing. Dara was great. And I totally had nailed my "who's hungry" line. Of course, there were some sour parts, mainly when Miss Welch got wasted on cheap wine and yelled at people in the audience for not laughing at certain jokes, or when Rylal got caught making out with one of the lesbian set builders. Didn't see that one coming. But even after all that, it was still a night that I will always remember fondly. If you want to see pictures, just Google Shane Dawson Fat Wearing Safari Hat 2006. You're welcome.